Primary 3, Second Midterm Science, Chapter 3, Fit for Life. Objectives: know the different food groups and their purposes, explore and research the adequate varied diet and exercise needed to keep healthy, know that some foods such as very sweet and fatty foods can be harmful to health, know how to keep my teeth healthy. You all know there are 5 main food groups. Now we see what are the 5 main food groups. First one, meat, eggs and beans. Second one, grains. Then fruits, vegetables, dairy products. So what are the 5 main food groups? Meat, eggs and beans, grains, fruits, vegetables and dairy products. Now here, food. Now we will see what are the foods that belongs to grains. Rice, bread, potato, cereals, pasta, bread. These foods belong to the group grains. Then fruits. You all know what are the fruits. Bananas, oranges, apples, pineapples, papaya, watermelons, grapes. Then vegetables. Vegetables, leeks, cabbage, carrots, broccoli, brinjals. Then dairy products. Dairy products, milk, yogurt, cheese, butter, curd, milk. Meat, eggs and beans. Meat, when you take meat, there are different types: chicken, mutton, beef, pork. Then fish, eggs, beans, peas, nuts. These are the foods that belong to each food group. Each food group contains nutrients. You all know each food group contains nutrients. Now we'll see what are the nutrients that contain in each food group. Now when you take grains, so what is the nutrient contain in grains? Carbohydrates. Then meat, eggs and beans. Nutrients, protein, vitamin A, vitamin B and iron. Fruits, vitamin C, vitamin E, potassium and fiber. Vegetables, vitamin A, vitamin C, zinc and fiber. Dairy products, protein, carbohydrate, calcium, magnesium and vitamin D. Now we'll see what are the functions of each nutrient. First one, carbohydrate. The function of carbohydrate is give us energy. Proteins repair our body and build strong muscles. Vitamin A helps us to see better in the dark. Vitamin B helps us convert the food we eat into energy. Vitamin C keeps us from falling sick. Vitamin D helps our body absorb calcium. Vitamin E helps slow down aging. Iron helps blood carry oxygen to all parts of our body. Potassium helps balance the amount of water in our body. Zinc helps our skeletons to grow properly. Calcium helps us build strong teeth and bones. Magnesium helps our body make proteins. Fiber helps us pass out feces easily. How can some foods be harmful to our health? Now, taking too much food that is rich in oils, fats and sugar can cause us to become overweight. When we eat too much of oil, fats and sugar, what will happen? Our body will overweight. Overweight people may also have pot bodies. Now here you can see a picture. Overweight people may also have pot bellies. Here you can see the person with the pot belly. Here The oils and fats in fried foods may also lead to heart diseases. So when you eat too much of oil and fat, that is not good for our heart. A heart attack can cause death. Taking too many foods that are sweet and sticky can lead to tooth problems. Too many sweets can form small holes on the surface of our teeth. When you eat too much of sweets, what will happen? That is not good for our teeth. Because of them, there may be holes on the surface of your teeth. Here you can see this picture now. Here the cavity. Here. This holes we call cavity. Here you can see now cavities here. Tips to keep our teeth healthy. What are the things that we have to do to keep our teeth healthy? Brushing our teeth twice a day, visiting the dentist regularly. You have to brush your teeth twice a day and you have to visit the dentist regularly. Without enough calcium and vitamin D for a long time, a person may end up with osteoporosis. Now, if you didn't take enough calcium and vitamin D, what will happen? The person may end up with osteoporosis. It makes your bones weak and more likely to break. Sugary foods contain carbohydrates in the form of sugar. Oils, fats, and carbohydrates give us energy. Oil, fats, and carbohydrates, they give us energy. Now here, the food that we have to eat and what the food that we have to avoid. Good fats. Good fats help to prevent heart diseases. So what are the food that contain good fat? Olive oil, salmon, fish oil, and avocado. Bad fats lead to heart diseases. Because of the bad fat, we will get heart diseases. So margarine contains bad fat, so margarine is not good for our body. Now here, sugary foods. Sugary foods, what are the sugary foods? Cakes, candies, toffees, chocolates, sugary drinks. So too much of sugary foods also not good for our body. Balanced diet. A diet refers to the choice of foods that someone eat. Diet means the food that we eat. So a balanced diet gives us the energy and nutrients we need. Balance means you have to take the nutrients, the amount that you need. So a balanced diet gives us the energy and nutrients we need. My plate. Now here, this is my plate. Here you can see grains, fruits, vegetables, this protein means meat and eggs, that one, and dairy products. Here this is the picture of my plate. Then you can judge the proportion of the foods you eat just by looking at your plate. You can judge the proportion of the foods you eat just by looking at your plate. Now tips on healthier eating. Fruits and vegetables should make up half of your meal. When you take meals, you have to take half fruits and vegetables. Then drink fat-free or low-fat meal. You have to drink fat-free or low-fat meal. And you have to cut down on foods that are high in salt. Too much of salt also not good for our body. Drink water instead of sugary drink. You have to drink water instead of the sugary drinks. Sugary drinks means fizzy drinks. Like now what you take from the shops. So dairy products contain lactose. Some people are lactose intolerant. Now here, this is a nutrition fact. This label of a nutrition fact. Here it includes here the nutrients that include their fats. Energy, fats, fiber, protein. So these calories Calories are units used to measure energy in food. Here, calories are the units that we use to measure the energy in food. Exercises. Exercise refers to any form of physical activity. We need to exercise regularly to keep our bodies and minds healthy. To keep our bodies and minds healthy, we have to do regular exercises. Now here, these are the benefits of exercises. Now we'll see one by one. Exercise helps to build strong muscles and bones. Exercise helps us to get energy from the foods we eat more efficiently. Exercise helps us to become more flexible so we can stretch more easily. Exercise prevents us from falling sick easily. Exercise reduces stress. Exercise keeps our hearts healthy. Pulse rate or heart rate. The number of times our heart beats in 1 minute. The number of times our heart beats in 1 minute. When we exercise, our pulse rate increases. When we are doing exercises, what will happen to our pulse rate? Our pulse rate will increase. And when we get older, our pulse rate will decrease. When we get older, our pulse rate will decrease. Now here, what is this? Stretching. Stretching helps to improve our flexibility. Stretching helps to improve our flexibility. This one, lifting weights help to build up our muscles. Lifting weight helps to build up our muscles. Now, exercises that good for our heart. Now, we'll see what are the exercises that good for our heart. Here, cycling, running, and swimming. So, what are the exercises that good for our heart? Cycling, running, and swimming. Lap band surgery. A lap band surgery is a surgery of the stomach and an elastic band is tightened around the top portion of the stomach. And Manuel Urip holds the record for the world's heaviest man. Now here you can see a diagram. Here now at the top portion of the stomach, here put an elastic band. The best way to keep a healthy weight is simply to have a balanced diet and watch the amount of food you eat. You have to have a balanced diet and you have to consider about the amount of the food that you eat. Then you can keep a healthy weight. Summary. Learn 5 different food groups and the nutrients contained in each group. Study about the MyPlate, learn the benefits of the exercises, learn about lap band surgery. Now here you can do this exercise, children. References, ScienceSmart Textbook 3, ScienceSmart Workbook 3.